Come on, clap your hands, everybody. Come on.
Well, let's give God a hand clap of praise wherever you're at, whether you're in your living room, bedroom, bathroom, deck, I don't know where you're at, but where you're at, let's give God some praise, let's give God some worship. Well, we welcome you to Antioch Missionary Baptist Church, our virtual worship service. We pray that you be blessed today and that there'll be a word said to you to help you, encourage you, lift your spirit up. Well, let's get ready for our service. God bless you and thank you so much for tuning in.
Beginning to the end, it will always be, it's always been you, Jesus, nothing else matters, nothing in this world will do.
Lord, you are good and your mercy endureth forever. Your word will fall on good ground, that souls will be saved, saints be revived, and backsliders will come back home. Lord, we're living in a time where we not in our own worship building as we once, but yet, Lord, we know that you're still able to use us wherever we are. And for that reason, Lord, we ask that your anointing will fall fresh upon me, that you will use me as your vessel. We give you the glory and the honor. It's in Jesus' name we pray. Amen.
Welcome into this place. Welcome into this broken vessel. You desire to abide in the praises of your people, so we lift our hands, oh, speak right now, as we lift our heart, as we offer up this praise unto your name. Can I just sing it one more time? One more time. Welcome into this place. Spirit of living God, move right now. Move right now. Welcome into this broken vessel. You desire to abide in the praises of your people, so we lift our hands, as we lift our hearts, oh my, as we offer up
this praise unto your name. Welcome to this place. Say we need you right now, Lord. Welcome into this broken vessel. You desire to abide in the praises of your people, so we lift our hands as we lift our hearts, as we offer up this praise unto your name. We welcome you, Holy Spirit. I invite you this morning, my brothers and sisters, those who are on social media with us today, I invite you to 2 Chronicles chapter 32, 2 Chronicles chapter 32. I just want to look at two verses while we're hearing this morning, 2 Chronicles chapter 32. We want to look at verses 7 and 8, verses 7 and 8. Verses 7 and 8. You'll find these words before us. Picks up by saying, be strong and courageous. Watch this. Be not afraid nor dismayed for the king of Assyria, nor for all the multitude that is with him. For there be more with us than with him. And then verse 8, it read like this, verse 8 for us. You find here in verse 8, it say, with him is an arm of flesh, but with us is the Lord, our God, to help us and to fight our battles. And the people rested themselves upon the word of Hezekiah, king of Judah. I want to talk briefly this morning, my brothers and sisters, from this subject, God's unlimited power. God's unlimited power. Wherever you're at it, you just repeat after me, God's unlimited power. God's unlimited power. My brothers and sisters, we live in a day where the word unlimited seems to be more of a sales pitch for a lot of people. Never shall forget when I would try to purchase a vehicle, one of the things I'm looking for is the unlimited service that they would render. And many times when we even shopping for some things in our own life, we want unlimited service. We don't want to be feel like we boxed in with just limited service. And here we find here in our text this morning, my brothers and sisters, this is a text that will show us God's unlimited power, that he's not a God that we can box and put him in a box, because he goes beyond the box mentality. And my brothers and sisters, this passage begins with King Assyria. It begins with the king of Assyria, and the king name was Sennacherib. Sennacherib was his name. And watch the text now. Watch the text. He was threatened to seize Judah of his own. This text here dealing with the king. His name means sin multiplied brothers. That's what his name is. His name means sin multiplied brothers. Would suggest to me that sin has a way of multiplying in all of us if we don't put a stop to it at the beginning. And according to the history record dealing with the king, my brothers and sisters, we find him that this was the same king that captured some 46 cities. This king, this same king, my brothers and sisters, captured over 200,000 people. This king. And yet the same king was trying to trap Hezekiah in Jerusalem like a bird in a cage. I think I'm going to teach now. Watch this. It was Hezekiah. Watch this. The same Hezekiah that was totally different than his parents. Why do I say that? I say that because his dad was one of the most wickedest rulers of all time. But yet his mother was also wicked as well. But yet King Hezekiah found himself living a different life than his parents. My brother and sister, have you ever been around certain people? They would do one thing, but you wouldn't find yourself trapped doing what they was doing. And here we find here that King Hezekiah, he trusted God. He loved God. And he was totally devoted to serving God. And here we find here is a perfect picture, my brothers and sisters, of God's unlimited sovereign power. Yes, it's God's power that delivered Hezekiah from the invasion of the Assyrians. It's God's power in this passage that teaches us how to trust him when you can't see him. And can I tell someone this morning that that same power that was there for King Hezekiah is here for us today. And I don't care how COVID-19 and all the other sickness and all the other problems and all the other situation you find yourself in, we still serve a God with unlimited power. And Hezekiah, my brother and sister, he does something proud to me trying to give some points this morning, that Hezekiah in this text gives us around about 5 preparations that he had to take in order to win the battle. And I want us to look at those 5 preparations that took place with King Hezekiah. Watch what it said here. Number one, Hezekiah had the military block off the water supply. That was one thing that he had to start with. Number two, Hezekiah had to reinforce the city wall. Third thing in preparation, right, we find here that Hezekiah had, watch it, he had to had a substantial number of weapons manufactured for the army. Then fourthly, Hezekiah, watch this, he organized the citizens into an army and he appointed officers within the city. And then the fifth thing he had to do, my brother and sister, he had to assemble the people at the city gate. And once they was at the gate, he had to encourage them in the Lord. And that's where I want to get right now, because that's prior to verse 7. And here we are now in verse 7. And we find in verses 7 and 8, my brother and sister, we find that Hezekiah, he shouts out to the people 4 words of encouragement. And those same 4 words I want us to be able to apply to our life, regardless of what we're going through. We can shout out 4 words of encouragement to help us to understand that we still serve a God with unlimited power. The first shout that we see in the text, my brothers and sisters, if we're going to shout out to the Lord dealing with his unlimited power, is the words of exhortation. Watch the text. It said, be strong. That word that he used here from the Hebrew means to fasten upon. In other words, you fasten yourself upon God. But watch what he said here. And he said, courageous. The word courageous here that he used here, my brothers and sisters, means to be alert. In other words, Hezekiah was telling them, you fasten yourself on God. But as you fasten yourself on God, always be alert. Watch the text here. He gives them words of exhortation. In other words, he wanted them to be resolved. He wanted them to be determined. He wanted them to stand against the enemy. Watch this. To the last person. In other words, don't you give up right now. And can I tell somebody here out there on social media, wherever you at, you stand boldly for God. You hold on to God. So we're going to shout today. We have to shout, number one, words of exhortation. I can't stay long this morning. I can't stay long. But watch this. Not only does he shout out words of exhortation, but secondly, he shout out words of evaluation. Why do I say that? It's right here in the text. When you look at verse 7, he gives us the second one right here. He said, be strong and courageous. Watch this. Be not afraid, nor dismayed. Watch this. For the king of Assyria. Watch the text. Watch the text. He said, be not afraid. Hebrew word is yara that he used here. Yara, it means to be frightened. He said, I don't need you to be frightened right now. But he tell him, not only do I don't want you to be frightened, he said, nor be dismayed. And the word dismayed that he used here from the Hebrew, it means, my brothers and sisters, to break down. In other words, he paints a picture as he evaluate the situation, as he look over the situation, is King Hezekiah. He's looking over the spiritual evaluation. He tells the people, watch this, don't be afraid. I know it look like it's more of them than us, but don't be afraid. I want to tell somebody right now, you may have less money than you have bills. Man, I want to tell somebody, you're going through some stuff. But today, I encourage you, look it over. Take a shot of evaluation. Look over the situation and understand this is not the time to be frightened. Watch the text once again. He said, nor be dismayed. I said it earlier. It means to break down. But watch the text. It really paints a picture that your enemies are in front of you. To the point that you're so frightened that you fall down. And can I tell somebody today, this is not the day that you fall down before God. If you're going to fall down, you only fall down to worship him. But you don't fall down because man seemed to be having you feel as though you cannot make it. So he shout out, my brothers and sisters. Number one, we have a shout of exhortation. Number two, we have the words of, watch this, evaluation. But then he gives us the third shout in the text. And this is the words of energy. The words of energy. Watch what he tells us right here in the 8th verse. He said, with him is an arm. That word arm here paints a picture of mighty. Watch this, of flesh. But with us, it is the Lord our God to help us and to fight our battles. They had great power in God. Yeah, they had great power. Watch the energy that here. They had the energy to fight. And I want to tell somebody today, you got to be a fighter for the Lord. And I know we keep hearing how COVID-19 is taking lives and other stuff is taking lives, but you still be a fighter. In other words, when Hezekiah is talking, God's people must know this one fact, they had greater power than the Assyrians. And that's what I want to leave with you, is his unlimited power. As I come to a close now, watch this. Number one, he shouts out words of exhortation. Number two, he shouts out words of evaluation. Number three, he shouts out words of energy. And then finally, he shouts out words of effect. What is the effect that we have here in the text? Right here in verse 8, he said, with him is an arm of flesh, but with us, it is the Lord our God to help us. I think I'm going to close right now. Watch this. To fight our battles. Watch the effect part in the text. And the people rested. What do you mean, rested? The word rested from the Hebrew means to lean upon. Yeah, they had to lean upon themselves, upon the words of Hezekiah, king of Judah. So as I leave you, we still serve a God with unlimited power. As I leave you now, we serve a God that still able to do all things. Matter of fact, Paul said in verse 9 of 1 Corinthians chapter 2. But as it is written, what no eyes have seen, nor ear heard, nor the heart of man imagined, what God has prepared for those who love him. Yes, I heard Isaiah said, for as the heavens are higher than the earth, yes, so are my ways higher than your ways, and my thoughts, I think I'm going to preach now. My thoughts are not your thoughts. And before I leave you, yes, Lord, I want somebody to know we serve a God with unlimited power. The same power he saved Israel. The same power he can save us. The same power that raised Jesus from the dead. The same power he can raise us. I don't know who you are this morning, but you ought to just give God some praise this morning. You ought to give God some worship this morning. And give God all you have for saving you. Unlimited power is the God we serve. How many know today he still got power over COVID-19? He still have power over your marriage. He still have power over your relationship. He still have power over your children. He still have power over your job. He still have power. Whatever you need, to try Jesus. What's his name? He's Mary's baby. Lily of the valley, bright and morning star. What's his name? He's my bridge over troubled water. What's his name? He's my sun, my sunshine. He's my moon in night. My stars give me the way. What's his name? Starving land. What's his name? A doctor in a sick room. What's his name? A lawyer in a courtroom. What's his name? But better yet, he's my savior. I say my savior. Is there anybody out there? No, he's your savior. You ought to just wave your hand. Just wave your hand. Hey! Thank you, Jesus. Woo! Yeah, thank you, Jesus, for unlimited power. I feel like preaching, y'all. God's unlimited power. Yes, I feel like preaching, y'all. Yes, he will. Woo! I gotta go. God's unlimited. Pray that something was said to help you, that you would turn your life over to him and know that God has unlimited power. If that word was for you today, you don't know him, as you pray with me to receive him as Lord and Savior of your life. Eternal God, we thank you for your word. We pray right now for that soul that do not know you, that they receive you today in their life. Lord, we ask right now that they confess with their mouth, believe in their heart, that God has raised their son from the dead, and thou shalt be saved. We thank you. We bless you. We give you the glory. It's in Jesus' name we pray. Amen. Amen. We pray once again something was said to help you, to encourage you for the word today. We thank you once again as we get ready for our tithes and offering at this time. Amen. We thank God for the word today as we get ready to give back to the Lord by way of tithes and offering. Let's bow our head right where we're at. Eternal God, we thank you for this day. Thank you for blessing us to be able to give back to you as you have blessed us. Now, Lord, we ask that you bless each and every one as they forgive those who are not, Lord. We ask a special blessing upon them that they're able to give the next time. Now, Lord, we cover them with your Son's blood. We know, Father God, as we give obedient to you, you'll open up windows and pours out a blessing. We speak it and decree it upon their life that they come short of nothing, Lord. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. All right, we have several ways that you can give your tithes and offering. Antioch, and also guests if you'd like to sow into the ministry. If you're local, you can drop it off at the church if you desire. There's a special area where you can drop the tithes and offering off. Secondly, you can mail your check in if you like to a P.O. Box, and that's Antioch Missionary Baptist Church, P.O. Box 1614, Carrollton, Georgia, 30112. And then thirdly, you can use the Antioch Clem Push Pay in order to pay your tithes and offering. With that Push Pay, there's several options that you can use. Your tithes and offering, you can also sow a seed for the pastor love offering within the Push Pay. And then fourthly, if you just like to pay a love offering or give a love offering to the pastor by way of his personal cash app, you can do so if you desire, and that is the $ Vincent Doors. Well, we thank you all so much, those who's able to give. We pray that you have a blessed week. Well, it's time to rock the house. It's time to rock this house. Let me give you benediction, and I'm going to do what I call my after party. Eternal God, we thank you for today. We thank you for your blessings. Thank you for allowing us to be able to hear your word and be able to worship you, Lord, even away from the building, but in our own homes, Lord. Now, Lord, we ask for your blessings upon us throughout this week. No hurt, harm will come upon us. And all that we do, Lord, you get the glory and you get the honor. Now to him who is able to keep us from falling, present us faultless before the throne of grace. Be unto him dominion, majesty, and power. Now, henceforth, and forevermore, let all of God's children
be saved. It's time to get out of here. Amen. I pray someone said, it's time for me to do my little Holy Ghost dance, and we're going to get on out of here. Y'all ready? Come on. Yeah. Woo. Come on, rock the house with me. Oh, y'all saw that? Yeah. Y'all can't do that. Y'all can't do that. I'm going to do it one more time. Watch. Oh, yeah. Somebody said I was in a juke. I ain't heard that word juke in so long. I don't go to no juke. I go to the house of the Lord. Bye.